Good evening, guys. Welcome to my channel. Today we are seeing the round number 15, the 15th round, from Spassky and Fisher, St. Stephen, 1992. I skipped round number 14 because it's really boring round. There is nothing to show, absolutely nothing. So I decided to jump over it and go to round 15 right away. This round features Mr. Fisher for the first time in white pieces. Like he didn't play e4, he played something else. He tried to survive Spassky, but Spassky was very well prepared. He was really confident and he did his job very well. So let's see the game. So Fisher with white played c4, e6, knight f3, knight f6, g3. d5, bishop g2, bishop e7, castle, and we have the Catalan opening, and this is the first time we see Fischer using that. d4, knight bd7, and here Fischer, like usually they play here queen c2 and then knight c3, but here Fischer played knight d2. Like this is not really the best move, but it's okay. Now Spassky knows that this bishop has to develop, so played b6. C takes d5 by Fischer. I think Fischer was scared of d takes c4 and then bishop b7 and this diagonal is open. So c takes, e takes, knight e5, knight bishop b7, and now Fischer here played knight to f3. Also, I'm not sure about this move either, but you know, when you have a mistake like this, your bishop actually stuck here on c1. You need to move him. If your knight is here on c3, this won't be an issue. So knight f3, but there was a bias to pay. Knight e4. You are giving black this wonderful square for free. Now, here, Fischer also could play here knight d7 if you want to. Queen d7 and then knight e5. But he didn't do it. He played bishop f4 instead. And here, Spassky played knight df6 right away. Like, he ran away with his knight. And again, I don't know why Fischer playing like this. I have no idea. Like, there's something weird here. So, rook c1 by Fischer. He's going to jump on c6 with the knight. c5, and Spassky saying he tried this again in another time. D takes, b takes. And those two bonds, we call them hanging bonds. Those bonds could be a weakness, could be a strength. It depends on the circumstance of the game. It's hard to defend them, and they get more and weaker every time you push them. So what's happened here is Spassky wants to use those two bonds to occupy the center and get small control of these squares. And he can handle the bishop of the rook on the c file, and the queen bishop on d5. That's very easy. Anyway, we'll make it more complicated. Knight g5 by Fischer, take, knight e4, take, and now bishop e4. And let's stop here a little bit because there is I think something better than this in the game. You can do better because white actually has a good position here. I think he should play actually knight d3 here. And the next move gonna be knight f4, putting pressure on the d5 square. But bishop e4 blade, d4, knight c4, having an eye on the bone on e3. And if white managed to play knight e3, let's say you played something silly like h6 and we allow white for knight e3. This bishop will become useless. This guy doesn't have anywhere to go. So, what's happened here? Spassky played e3, and he knows the pawn is nothing in comparison of this activity. And if you guys notice, as I did, Spassky playing in Fischer's style against Fischer himself. Fischer is the guy who's sacrificing, he's opening diagonals, etc. Usually Spassky doesn't really take risks anyway. Usually he's a good defender, a good endgame player, but not in tactics. But e3 surprised me actually. So f3, by white took ad8, queen b3, rook fe8, rook c3, and the pawn, if he's under pressure, what's happening, what's gonna do? Bishop d5, rook fc1, and g6 by Spassky. Spassky's keeping all the cards on the table. Basically, you cannot take the pawn on e3 like this because you're gonna lose your queen. So what's gonna happen here? This is the question. Queen a3. So Fischer ran away from the winning knight and attacking the pawn on c5. Bishop f3. This is a very good move by Spassky. He's sacrificing the bishop for pawn in exchange of this move in particular. He wants to go for the blood and he wants to make a queen. Now white of course stopped him. Rook d1. Now you cannot play this move here. This is a mistake because black will take here, and he can have another queen. So don't do that. So what's happened is king f2, rook e1, king e1. So Fischer using the king to protect himself. Queen d7, and look, the queen is coming to h3, and the rook is defending the pawn. Queen b3, queen h3, knight e3 to block this diagonal. It's very important. Queen h2, g4, rook b8, queen d5, rook b2, and here Fischer actually in danger, but Fischer found the best way to play this position. He is the tactician here. He played the queen d8 check, king g7, and now knight f5. And this is a very nice move. The king has no way to go, so he has to accept the sacrifice. Then I have check, and it's a draw by repetition. Three moves repetition. The position itself being repeated three times. If you go to f8, we'll go back to d8. Go back, we'll come back, and it's a draw. Very nice game by Spassky, and Fischer escaped in the last moment by using tactics. Hope you guys like the video. Like, share, subscribe to the channel, and have a good day. Bye-bye.